Have you ever wished that you could write better just like your favorite author? In this video, we're going to unleash the power of the three writing masters, Gemini, GPT-4, and Mixtral. We're going to dive in the strengths and weakness and the secret sauce of copying anyone writing style. Actually, this is an MVP that I have been working on lately. The whole idea that you can take any link or tweet or a post of LinkedIn and you give it this chameleon and it will automatically understand the writing style and the format of this author or the post and automatically and it will be able to make a copy in this format and tone and voice of this post using the best model that we're going to figure out in this video. So this is basically step one for this app, figure out which is the best model that we can use in our case or maybe multiple model because you will be surprised about the results. So we are going to build an API for interacting with the three different models. I'm going to walk you through the process of connecting to Gemini, Mixtral, and of course, you know about GPT. We did it so many times in this channel. And also compare the result of each different one. The first step is how to handle the prompt engineering. For copying someone's style, we need to find the basic prompt that we're going to work with in our app. The first thing that we normally start with is instructions and the context. But we're adding style on top of it because we are copying someone's style. So for example, write me an email, which our instruction for my boss is the context in the style of J.K. Rowling, which the style of our prompt. And actually, J.K. Rowling will be more magical and have this kind of soft tone and try to capture you like in Harry Potter. As you can see, it created an email using this kind of format. So we're going to create a template for our prompt that we're going to use for the three different models. Here is one of the templates that we're going to work with. Write a type of text which we're going to hear about what type of content that we're creating is a post, an email about a topic. Here, for example, we're going to talk about whatever what you want. Maybe provide a more extended text about the topic. Target audience, for example, LinkedIn, Twitter users, in the style of the provided example, capture its tone, voice, vocabulary, and the sentence structure. And finally, the example. Here we're going to put the example that we wanted to copy. It's a real example. Let's test it out. Write a post about Mojo, the new subset language for Python for LinkedIn in the style of the provided example. And I gave it here an example of the writing style that I wanted to copy and hit it run. It's not exactly the ideal result that I wanted to, but it's a good start to understand how we're going to achieve what we want. Now let's take a look for our code. I have one endpoint right now, just testing the stuff out. It has three different functions that call three different APIs. One for Mixer, one for Gemini, one for OpenAI. Let's start with the OpenAI because it's the easiest one to write. You already know how to do it. I'm using the regular OpenAI library, trying to create a chat here. I'm telling the system, analyze this example of text tone, voice vocabulary, and sentence structure, and apply the identify elements to all your feature outputs. Basically, I'm giving here an instruction for all the posts that will come after this message. The example, I give it one example over here, is the same one. I actually got this kind of writing style from someone called Jasmine Alec. He's one of the best, if not even the number one on LinkedIn in terms of writing. His writing style is what terrorized me. Like as you can see, he's super structured. He has this kind of method of making clean posts that your eye can scan and read easily. And this is what I wanted to go for. Back to our code, we have here the content and example. And I give the role of the user, send it a topic, which basically is a prompt that we want. And finally, we get the final result from the OpenAI. This is easy, okay? I want to take a look to Gemini and Mixtral first, then compare the three results in the end. To start with Gemini, we need to get an API key for it. All I have to do is go to ai.google.dev, click get key in Google AI Studio. Straightforward, you don't need anything. All you have to do is just on Google account and you can access it. After that, you can go to here, get API key, and you will find your API key over here and we can start using it. The second step of using Gemini or any AI Google model, you have to go to Google Generative AI and download the SDK for Node.js. Actually, it's very straightforward. They have a decent documentation I wanted to show you, which is over here. It have a different language and different documentation for each one. We have Python, Android, Go, and Node.js and JavaScript. And even if you want to use Flutter with it or iOS, it's already there. So let's check out the Node.js, and it tell you immediately what you need to do. Get your API key, install the generative AI, how to set up it and up and running, select the model name, and you have different options actually. Create text only, text and image, and conversation, which means chat, and you can use a stream. And we're gonna set up a two different kind of Gemini APIs right now, but you're talking to the same model. And here we did a same thing, set up the generative Google generative AI, give it the API key, and we have here using the Gemini Pro, which is the last model, I think. And I'm here starting chat by giving the taking the model, call it start chat, give it something called history, not messages, and role for each one, the model and the user. The bars is basically the content of our message. And finally, generative configuration is the, you can both hear the max output tokens and stuff like this. Then after that, we have to send message to the chat using chat.send message using the topic. I'm using sending the topic, which is the prompt. And finally, we get the final response. I'm extracting text from response and return it back. This is a second example of using Gemini. Actually, it's a much simpler one, but it gave me much better result for some reason. And instead of give it history and a chat, we just create the model and send something called the first prompt. The first prompt will have the template or instruction for the entire chat that will come. And one of the coolest things about generative Google GS or the library they created, you automatically can count tokens. You just have to give it the prompt and it will tell you the total counts of each token, if each prompt that you're sending. And after that, I use the model to generate content and I'm sending the prompt. And that I just wait for result and I get it back. But I don't need the first result of the response. I just immediately send the prompt or topic to the model and get the text back. You don't have to do a lot to make it up and running, and there is no error. Honestly, I found it even easier than OpenAI in terms of documentation. The last one is the Mixtral model. To access it in API, the best solution that I found right now is fireworksai. It's a platform for developer if you wanted to use the open source model, and you can start with free. Actually, you just have to log in and get your account. I have already an account. Go to AI keys and you'll automatically get your AI key from here, copy it from here and go to the model. Here you have a list of different models that we can use. We have Mixtral, the Hugging Face version, and the Mixtral instruct itself, and you can choose whatever what you want and go over here. When you find the model that you want, you will get that kind of chat that you can start talk to is. And it will give you like some sort of a free kind of, I think it give you a free $1 to use it. But if you click the API over here, you can get code that you, if you want to use, if you want to talk to this kind of API. And here it tell me what I need to write for in terms of kind of chat. This is the kind of code that you want to write for chat. And it's this TypeScript. I mean, also JavaScript. You just have to copy this, change temperature and max token, and play with it a little bit, and put your API key over here. You see it in my code. Mixtral, it's the same thing. I created a function that have the body, have every detail of the body. I made the max token 1000 because I don't need that much. 0.5 is the temperature. I disable the stream. I don't want to stream actually for this kind of version. I'm just doing, trying to figure out which best model. And then I create the response using fetch. I send the compilation. Basically, I just don't set compilation to Mixtral. And here I give it the API that I have. And I send the body in a stringify and I wait until the response come back and I extract only the text of our message. Here in the body, I give it the model of that I want, the Mixtral 8x7b instruct, and the template that I have. And the topic actually is set inside the role, user, content, and here is the topic. And the other role is the assistant, and the content of it is the template. And one last note about the fireworks, I wanted to show you the pricing because people might wonder about it. For example, the Mixtral 8x7b, it's already up there. The 1 million input tokens, it have 40 cents, and the 1 million output token is $1 $0.16. So it's, I think it's much cheaper. I think it's a very decent for this kind of model because we have 1 million input and 1 million output token. So if each user is using 1 million input in the month and 1 million output in the month, we have like almost $2 for one user. We have to think about the pricing in terms of creating an MVP that we go into deploy and create billing around it so we can cover the bills of this app. And finally, the moment that we have been waiting for, comparing between the three results of the three different models. I have three here. I have the three different tabs for each one, as they are empty right now. And this dummy prompt that will send, I'm asking it to create a post from a text that I provided about Sora, the new OpenAI, and talk about the capability and limitation of Sora from OpenAI. Let's hit send and see what will happen. As I said, this is Gemini. I locked the power of text-to-video Sora from OpenAI. Or it's talking too much, honestly, but there is some sort of format here. Okay, it's not that bad, but not the best. Let's check GPT. Okay, here if it's give us this kind of, I think it's the format is a bit bad here, but it's the best one, honestly, in terms of trying to format it as the same copy. Finally, Mixtral. Oh my god, Mixer, it didn't write a post to write it a book. I don't know why they are talking too much. Actually, here, this is the final one, Mixer from text to video Sora capability. I think it's created two different one. Because here is until here. This is the one, the first one. Example of text that can be covered into a video using Sora. Here, the second one. This is a very good results, actually. The very, very, very good result from Mixer. Under the rating writing hack, write less to say more, ever cut yourself saying too much. Semi-significant, but it's very, yeah, it's kind of stupid, but the format is very good. I mean, it's if we provide it with a better prompt right now, it's gonna give us a better result. One more final try before we end it to see how the prompt can affect the result of the model. I tell it here to write a post about the Mojo, the new subset language for Python, which I use through Gemini, and the target is the LinkedIn. And we hit send and wait for the result of the three model. Okay, this is the result. Actually, Gemini is not only to write a post, but also went out and gave us an example of the code of Mojo. And I kind of feel like it didn't capture the tone or the format of the post at all, but it wrote a decent post, honestly. And right now for GPT-4, so as you can see, the GPT-4 have almost the same format of the post that we give it over here, the underrated hack post. It have almost the same kind of structure, one line questions and 3 points, then one title, one text, then more points, then the ending. As you can see here, actually, it did the same thing in the here one line with the text, then line, then window with the points, as you can see over here. Then one more question is very good. Then window with more line and more options, and the ending at the end is actually copying the same emojis. As you can see, the repost one here is the same one here, and the one emoji in the end. And the final one, the also Mixer did very well when in term of trying to capture the tone, the voice, the vocabulary, and the sentence structure. Yeah, it's the result of it is not that perfect, but I think I can improve the temperature of Mixer and get better results. And the last one in term of winning is Gemini. For some reason, it didn't capture the tone, the vocabulary, or the sentence structure at all. So deciding the first phase of this app, we are going with GPT-4 and Mixer, and we have to play a little more with the prompt to make it more perfect. I think GPT-4 doesn't need any more playing around. It's almost perfect the way it is. And Mixer comes second in terms of the structure, and Gemini basically, we don't need it. It didn't do anything very well. So yeah, it's GPT and Mixer. Finally, thank you for watching this video. My name is Hussam Eddin, or simply you can call me Sam. And I want you to subscribe for this channel and tell me down below which model that you think can perform better. Are you surprised by this kind of odd result? Maybe if you have more information about prompting Gemini or Mixtral that I didn't know about, let me know. I would love to know about them down there in the comment. With that being said, see you in the next video.